that Halloween in the U.S. became a quote-unquote family-friendly event. And treats were given to young people because of the burgeoning candy industry. And Halloween became an instant commercial success, now only second to Christmas. The sales of costumes, candy, decorations, and movie events have turned it into a profitable $6 billion industry annually. Can I have my next Table Topics volunteer? Your question is, Mr. Sims, should Halloween be celebrated as it is today?
Well, first of all, I can't sing. I think it was Father Bond in my sophomore year at Fairfield University said, "You are one of the few people who actually has a tin ear." And unlike Scott, I don't have any memories of mooning anyone, although there were times when I consumed a good amount of alcohol at school, so it might have happened, but no, it doesn't recollect in my mind. I think anything that you celebrate is worth celebrating because of the fact that we live in a troubled world. Today, all of a sudden, on Facebook, I see a number of my friends from New York City saying, I'm safe, I'm recording that I'm safe. And lo and behold, right in the shadow of the World Trade Center, a terrorist up with a truck killed at least 8 people this afternoon. And what they said is the mayor and other leaders in the city said, we're going to have a parade tonight, and we're going to go forward and have that parade. And I think that that is the way that we have to look at not just Halloween, but almost anything that we celebrate. We can't let the terrorists win. And even as difficult as it might be to pick up and just act normally, I think we need to do more of that. And if acting normally might involve a little bit of singing, break out in song. And if you need to moon somebody, just be careful. Make sure you're not mooning an off-duty policeman or one of the fellas from that redneck Toastmaster club. They may take umbrage to your mooning.
Thank you.